You're talking about them oysters. All I can say is, anytime you fool with oysters, you better be damn careful about oysters.
Hey, y'all. Got a pump. Check it out. Got a nice one right here. Pretty heavy. About maybe a 1 pounder, maybe 2 pound, I don't know. Nice, ain't it? Pomp. Hey y'all, Sapo here. Somebody was asking, how is it out there? Well, let me tell you, let me show you. First of all, got these cool clouds, man. Look at this. That's the shape of Texas right there, the coast. That's why those clouds are doing that. See that? Isn't that cool? But now we're over here to the Gulf of Mexico. And I got two rods out. I got one Pompano so far, and my friends down there, they got about 5 or 6. And I'm hanging here at Jim's log. Oh, look, 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 oh, look. That's what you call Pompano. I gotta go now. Bye. Okay, folks, I'm back. Oh my God, this thing was jumping. This is about a 2 or 3 pounder. It was jumping 3 feet out of the water. I didn't know what it was even. You saw that rod buckle over. Oh, I have a guest. Say hi to everybody.
Hi.
And the two dogs.
My two dogs.
Look at that, folks. That's a doozy. It's really fat, man. They're coming by in schools. Get out here. Jim's log. Line up the rods, people.
Okay, that's what...
But don't leave them too long in the icebox.
No, indeed.
I use mine the same day when I get them.
Oh, yeah. You see, that's...
Okay, folks. Got another one. This is a little smaller. This is the smallest one so far. It's not really, this is a HDX tournament, but that thing doesn't bend that easy, and it had it buckling over pretty good. So it's my third one. I think it's starting to hit, the tide's going out and it's gonna start stopping. And then that's when they're gonna go crazy. So when you get off work, get out here now.
I believe that's what my mama died from.
Yeah,
she ate some oysters, and from what I can understand,
yeah,
that's what caused it to get.
Okay, let me make another report. The last one, I got a big old hit, man, about a 3 pound pump. Maybe it's gonna happen again. Usually if you take a piss or you start playing on your iPhone, that's when you get a bite. Anyway, the water is gin clear. Do you hear me? Gin clear. Out there it's aqua green or emerald green, whatever you wanna call it. If you got costas on, you can see everything. It's beautiful. The beach is packed like a freeway, like I-10. But not that many cars. The dunes, I haven't gone over there, I'm sure it's dead carcasses and whatnot, but this is where we're gonna have Pomp Fest in 1 month from now, and it's gonna be awesome, y'all. Awesome. We're gonna have down there the merry-go-round and the Ferris wheels, then the roller coaster will be right about over there. No, I'm kidding. But you'll feel like you're on one the next morning, don't believe me. But see, we can park up there. We'll find a spot that's kind of cut out. Down there it's flatter. We'll put our cars up in the dunes. And that's how we see it. Leanne's down there. She's catching pomps also. Everybody's catching pomps. I mean, I've been getting reports up and down the beach. Some pelicans out there. There's a lot of birds working offshore. I can't cast that far, but I've cast it as far. The GDX is unbelievable rod, y'all. That thing, that's what I caught the 3 pounder on, and man, you talk about fun. Awesome rod, Nick Meyer. The HDX tournament bud is awesome too. I had a pump that was so strong he was bending it, and that's not that easy. It's got an AVET, which is a killer reel. Guy down here, he's been running back and forth to his rod. I'm sure he's getting pumps. They're in now, folks. It's the time of the year. Tis the season to be jolly and fill your ice chest up with folly. What a dud.
Oysters, that's the most dangerous thing out.
And it was oysters, I believe, that she'd gotten sick on.
Yeah.
Too mean for and whatever. So, man.
Got another one, y'all. This guy's pretty big. Let's check it out. Whoa. That day's still kicking like crazy. Anyway, caught this on the GDX also. And it's awesome, man. If y'all can get out here, get out here. Whenever there's clear water like this, this is the year of the pomp. The red tide only made them hungrier because all the bait's gone. So,
listen to Sapo. He says, get out here. Get out here now.
Don't fool them damn oysters. Leave them alone.
Oh, you can bomb like
Let's see what I got so far. about that many. Can you see them? I'm not gonna pull them out. They're nice. They're staying cold right now. Don't forget to join the club. South Texas Pomp Hunters. Look, folks. You might think the group's dead, but it's not. It hibernates during the summer. And then every fall, it explodes. And it comes to life. It gets resurrected like Frankenstein's monster. Believe me, folks. Believe me. So make sure you join South Texas Pomp Hunters. Even if you're not into fishing, come on over. You know, we show how to cook. We tell stories. Bob Gilda posts all kinds of weird, you know, stuff that has nothing to do with fishing and stuff like that. But it's okay. It's all good, folks. Come on down. Okay, here's the final tally. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Does that sound right? Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, cool, I got 10. They're big. I got from the biggest to the front to the littlest in the back. I threw back anything under like 13 inches. I said 14 earlier, but anyway, take a look at these. Very nice. These are about maybe two and a half pounders, then you get down to your 1.5 pounders, then you get down to your 3/4 of a pound, maybe 1 pound. And these are all good eating pompanos, folks. This is one of the best fish in the Gulf of Mexico, to tell you the truth. But there's the final tally. So it was a great day at the beach, and I'm glad I came out here. I fished alone and it was very peaceful. And I think my doctor would be proud of me. So, Sapo, out.